So we did a National Institute of Mental Health funded longitudinal drug research program from 1968 through 1972, approximately. We had a random and a representative sample of 10% of the entering freshman class at UCLA. The conclusion was that it was certainly a physiologically, medically speaking, a safe recreational drug compared to almost everything else. And as it turns out, that it had a lot of medicinal applications.
As we see it from a typical psychiatric...
I'm a psychiatrist, professor emeritus at UCLA Medical Center. I've been there since 1962 and working since 1965 in the drug abuse field. I had a chance to serve on President Nixon's National Commission on Marijuana and Drug Abuse for 2 years.
If you had a substance like this that had these effects, I feel quite confident that there'd be a move to put it on a prescription basis, a controlled medical basis, in which the issue would depend on what the benefit was to the user.
We didn't find a lot of side effects that were problems from marijuana, and we were very encouraged by what we saw, but somewhat dismayed by some of the responses that we got from other researchers. One researcher, for example, would say that in his studies, marijuana caused central nervous system toxicity and therefore shouldn't be allowed to be used by anybody. When we pressured him to say what he meant by central nervous system toxicity, which is a scary word, he said, "I mean drowsiness."
The greatest harm did not derive from any inherent psychopharmacological effect of the substance, but rather from the way we as a society were treating it.
The DEA considers marijuana to be an illicit drug, and it's that way because Congress placed marijuana as a Schedule I substance. It has no accepted medical use and a high potential for abuse.
DEA is not responsible for enacting the laws relative to controlled substances, in this case marijuana. That, of course, falls within the purview of Congress. DEA has a responsibility, as long as marijuana is a Schedule I controlled substance, to enforce it.
What's striking from the social standpoint is how much more harshly we deal with marijuana than alcohol. Clearly, alcohol causes more deaths, it causes more injuries, it makes people's judgment impaired more often than marijuana.
It's just a matter of what mind-altering substances are compatible with what value system.
Marijuana has been identified as a substance preferred by the counterculture, by people who were seen to reject American society. First, it was jazz musicians, not just black musicians, but integrationists. Remember, this is a very racist society. The whole notion of integration in the 20s and 30s and even to the 40s was terribly frightening to people. And these were blacks and whites who hung out together, maybe even married each other. So marijuana got a bad rap there. And then it became the drug of the hippies, of the war protesters. So marijuana gets stigmatized for its cultural implications far beyond any rationality.
You know,